Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And you ever wanted to get some help optimizing the size of your model, but you can't share it out because it contains personally identifiable information, or you don't have access to the PBIX file? What do you do? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you. Stay tuned. Find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right, so you got this model and you're concerned that it's gonna get too large and you want to get some help optimizing the size of the model. Adam and I talk about this all the time on our live stream and during videos and the sessions that we speak at. And I can't share the PBIX file because it contains some sensitive data, or I don't have access to the PBIX file. What do I do? Well, there's three tools that you can use to get the VPAX file. And I'm not gonna talk about all the details of the VPAX file. Marco and Alberto, they've done great videos explaining exactly what the VPAX file is. But in this video, I'm gonna show you how you can actually get that VPAX file and share it with someone who has the skills to help you optimize the size of your model, all right? So you guys know what I like to do. Enough of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. Before you get started, you're gonna need one of these tools. You'll need either Bravo, DAX Studio, a Tabular Editor. And if you head out to the interwebs, if you go to bravo.bi, you can download Bravo from there. If you go to daxstudio.org, you can download DAX Studio there. And if you want to spend a little money, you can download Tabular Editor 3 from here. But you can use either one of these tools, okay? If you have access to the PBIX file, my recommendation is make sure there's a sufficient amount of data in this model so that once you share it with someone, they actually get a good representation of your data so they can give you some suggestions on how to optimize your model. If you go to external tools, click it, it'll launch Bravo or whichever tool connected to the model. There's lots of great details here, and Marco's published a video, and you can go check that video out. The VPAX file is just metadata. It's just some queries ran against your model to obtain all the metadata about it. There's no data contained within this VPAX file. And so you just download the VPAX file and I'll save it. And now I can just email this to anyone or put it on a OneDrive and share the link to that OneDrive. And now you may be thinking, well, Patrick, I like using Bravo, but how could we get the VPAX if we don't have access to the PBIX file? So what you could do here in Bravo, you would choose connect to Power BI service and then go find the data set you want, or you can search for it and just choose the one you want. Depending on the size of the model, Bravo could take some time to analyze it. Once it's finished analyzing, it'll actually show you the details of that model, and then you can download the VPAX files. Again, not going to go into the details, but you can see this is a pretty big model. It's 6.44 gigs and this particular column is taking 31%. But if you wanted to share this with someone, and I don't have access to the PBIX file, I connected directly in the service, all I need to do right now is choose this and download that VPAX, and then I can share it however I want to share it. So that's how you do it with Bravo. But maybe you're a Tabular Editor type of person. You can go back to your model if you have access to the PBIX file, launch Tabular Editor already connected to that model, and then down at the bottom, you're going to see where it says VertiPack Analyzer. Click it and then choose Collect Stats, and then it's going to collect all your stats. You can see there's the tables, there's the columns, relationships, partitions, there's the summary. You can see this is a rather small model, but then you can click export and it's going to create your VPAX file for you. This is if you have access to that local PBIX file. If you don't, open up Tabular Editor as a standalone tool. Choose this icon right here, open model from database, pop in your XMLA endpoint. When you click OK, it's going to give you a list of the databases. Choose the database and then you'll see all the information about your model. You can see I'm connected to my insane, amazing workspace. The steps are the same. Click VertiPack Analyzer, choose collect stats. It'll take a little while. If the model is large, once it collects all the stats, you would simply click export and then you would have your VPAX file. Now, if you're like me and DAX Studio is your tool of choice, just go ahead and click DAX Studio and it's going to open up. Go to advanced, choose view metrics. You'll see your metrics there. And then all you need to do is click export metrics and there's your VPAX file. Really, really simple. If you don't have access to the PBIX file, all you need to do is choose connect, pop in your XMLA endpoint. It'll populate your models here. Go to advanced, choose view metrics. Once it loads all of those metrics up, simply choose export metrics and boom, all three of these products allow you to get access to your VPAX file and import those VPAX files. And so in DAX Studio, if I choose import and I click it, it's just gonna upload those metrics. You can see that's my big 6.44 gigs. If I go to Tabular Editor, same thing, import my metrics, go find a VPAX file, boom, there you go. And even in trusty Bravo, you can do the same thing. If I just say open a VertiPack Analyzer file, go to browse, choose it, boom. There you go. So when you ship it off to that person, they're going to use one of these tools to analyze the model and give you some suggestions on how you can optimize the size of your model. All right, what do you guys think? Did you know that you can get the VPACS file in so many ways? And did you know you can share it confidently and not worrying about anyone getting access to your sensitive data? Did you know this? Well, if you didn't, I'd love to know. I'd love to know if you found another way to do it, or if you're running into any challenges, you know what to do. Let's continue the conversation. Where? In the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, give me a big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video, the VPACS.